In this video, we're gonna talk about the best beginner dirt bike on a budget. All right, guys, we're out here in beautiful Austin, Texas. It's bright and early, not so bright, and we're gonna talk about how to get you guys into the best beginner dirt bike on a budget. So there's gonna be three key points that we're gonna be looking at here. Is we're gonna be trying to find a trail bike, which I think every beginner should start on so they can get their technique under control before they go out to a racetrack. The second thing we're gonna talk about is sizing, knowing where you're at with that. And the third thing that we're gonna talk about is buying used. So the first key point I wanna talk about is making sure that you buy a trail bike first. The reason for that is they're just more controllable. What I mean by that is they have an air-cooled engine, they have a little less suspension, the height of the bike is a little less. So if you buy an adult-sized bike that's a race bike or a race trail bike, they're gonna be, you know, 3 to 4 to maybe even 6 inches taller than these. So for a guy like myself at 5'7", you're kind of tippy-toeing. So what I want you to think about when you're buying these bikes is, am I buying a bike that I can control? So working off our first key point here, I want to just show you guys real quickly the differences what you're going to see in a trail bike so you can spot it when you're looking for your bike. You're going to have a conventional style fork, which means that the bigger part of your fork is down low, the smaller part is up top. On a race bike, you're going to see the opposite all the time. The second thing is you see that there's no radiators behind these fins. On a race bike, you're gonna see that. The reason for that is this is an air-cooled engine. It produces less power and less torque, which is more manageable for a new rider. Also, the rear shock is gonna be a little less burly, a little less bulky, a little less rigid, I would say, compared to a race bike. On this specific model, I would say this is good for riders from, say, 5'2 to about 5'8 or 5'9. Hey guys, stick around to the end. We have a cool bonus tip for you about these bikes. And one last thing is you'll notice that the front here has a disc brake. And then when you move to the back on these bikes, just to save for cost, they're gonna have a drum brake, which is, it's gonna work for you, but it is gonna be a little less powerful than your race bike. But I think the biggest thing that you should think about is this bike isn't gonna go super fast. So when you're just learning to let the clutch out, when you're just learning to get around a smooth surface, this is gonna be the safest way to go. And in fact, we take a lot of racers when they come here and train, and we put them on these bikes so they can open up their brain and think about their technique rather than thinking about controlling a very powerful bike. The second thing we're gonna talk about is buying the right size bike. Okay, like I said previously, I would say 5'3 to about 5'8 on a 125 version of these trail bikes. And they do have, I think Honda makes like a 250, Yamaha makes a 230. So you can go up if you're gonna be a little taller adult, say 5'8 and above, you may look into that. But what my rule of thumb is when you hop on one of these bikes, come on over here with us. When you hop on one of these bikes, you wanna just be able to sit on here and have both feet touching the ground. Ideally flat-footed, so you don't want to be where you're here, just barely able to sit on the bike because you're not balanced when you're learning how to take off. Remember, the most comfortable we can feel when we're first learning how to ride a motorcycle, the better. So even if that's sizing down a little so we can feel like we're on the bike rather than off the side of the bike when we're learning how to go, that's going to be tremendously safer. We are trying to make you more videos, but like 70% of the people watching this video aren't subscribed. If you could just take a second, hit the subscribe button, maybe even a like and comment to help us keep building these videos. You do understand that's how we generate money to keep giving this free content away. We would super appreciate it because we love doing this for you. The third key point we're going to talk about is buying the bike used. Now this is going to take some studying on your part to understand what to look for, and we do have a video buying used bikes. So check that out so you have an understanding of what to look for. But just for instance, this is a 2019 CRF 125F that we paid roughly around $3,300 out the door for. Okay, this was a brand new bike. We got this to run into our Learn to Ride program to make sure we had a reliable bike, fuel injected, a little better quality than what this would be. This is gonna be, I think, a 2013 or 2012 TTR 125 Yamaha that I think we paid around $1,300 for on a good deal. And that's because I have a good eye for it. I can search Craigslist, I can search Facebook Marketplace, I can search all these outlets to buy things from and know like that bike hasn't been used that much. It's at a good price point. Even if I have to put a couple hundred bucks into it, we're, you know, half the price of what we got in this one. So think about that. If you're willing to, I say this with anything, if you're willing to do the studying and buy used, you can save so much money. And there are so many people that buy dirt bikes out there and then don't end up riding them, and you can find these garage finds for half the price of what you would pay for a new bike. Now, as you get better, it is nice to go buy a new bike and have something fresh that you can kind of upgrade to your liking. But when you're just getting going, it's all about the rider. It's way less about the bike. So find something that's reliable, find something that looks decent, and then go for it. All right, the bonus tip is here. And we're gonna talk about the capabilities of these bikes. I think a lot of people steer away from buying a trail bike because they don't think they're able to ride it on a real track. And the key is getting your skill set together before you ride on a real track. But the truth about this is me and the coaches here will take these bikes and jump these 40-foot tabletops no problem, right? And hit these ruts on these tracks like no problem, okay? So the truth is that you could take this to your local motocross track. Is it gonna be as fast as everyone else? No, but that's the point of it, is like, we don't want a bike fast that we're trying to learn how to do things on. So think about it, like, don't let your ego steer you away from buying a bike that you can learn quicker on. And of course, you'll be able to upgrade the bike, especially if you buy it at a deal. You may even be able to sell it for more than what you bought it for and then go buy a race bike when your technique is there and ready. All right, guys, we're building the subscriber list through email so you guys can stay up to date on what we're doing. We've had a lot of people ask about camps and lessons here, so we're building a subscriber base for that. If you'd like to put your email in, the link is in the description below, and you also get a free jumping tip video when you do that. We hope this helps you along when buying your first bike. If you did like this video, we've got plenty more over here. Don't forget to hit subscribe. We got Instagram videos dropping weekly here, and our Patreon account needs you. We'll see you next time.